aggressive and go wild with fun. Hello, my baby.
You must be a hero.
Yeah, you know, when you put it like that, I guess it does, you know, make sense.
You are a Charlie, you are a Charlie, Charlie, hero. Take back this, because we're all going to die someday. No, no, please, don't come in, please, no, I don't want to die, please, that's not my
favorite. We can have fun on the jungle gym after you tell me what you two were doing at the time of the murder. Well, that's a nice story and all, but doesn't really answer my question.
Did you want to film or anything?
Alright, yeah. What about that?
What? That?
Yeah.
I mean, it's kind of cool, but it doesn't make him feel any better, but...
Yeah, no, I didn't think so. Okay,
but I've only seen you two before. You're trying to mess with me. Get out of my head! Get out of my head!
Get out of my head!
Of hard candy for the journey, Charlie.
Oh, no, thank you, Grandma. I'm fine. Thank you, though.
Born for me.
excuse me, Mr. Boss?
Wait. One sec.
God damn it. Okay, go. What's up?
I am going to be alone forever.
Why don't we go for a drink, man? It's on me.
Excuse me, sir. Very tough with everything. Everything's been going on with my life. I know.
By the way, I just have to note that it was only Pim that yelled something. I didn't say anything.
I think it's because he drank a green potion from a stranger.
I don't think it's because of the potion I drank. I think it's just because of allergies.
That is not allergies, Charlie.
The biggest surprises are behind me. Dude, I warned you. I said I was going to do that if you did that again.
On the condition you bury me in the beautiful Chinese Shanghai Pinehurst, my hometown.
Oh, yeah, we will definitely go to China to bury you, man. He probably tastes even better right now than he did before.
You know, what do they taste like? I've never tried a century before.
Really? Okay, you have to try it at least once. I'd be honored.
Now I'm the one who's honored to be in the presence of such a hero.
Well, maybe it was your song that helped me become a hero.
Well, maybe I like that.
I just wanted my cheese.
I just wanted my cheese.
Like I said, it came out like green and chunky. I've never seen it like that before.
Yeah, like I said, I'm not a doctor, so you should probably talk to someone that understands that stuff more. How many people killed this guy? It's all good, it's fine. It's just that these guys started doing construction outside of my place and like six.
That means we legally can all go free! Yay!
I don't think it means that, I'm just...
I hope that if you can destroy them, they always do. And they did. Great. I forgot it. Cool. Just what I wanted. Exactly what I wanted, actually. Cool.
Time. Wait, Pim, I can cheer you up.
It's Mormu! You voted and we listened! This cannot be undone!
We're making Mr. Frog one of the richest and most powerful men on the planet.
It's a Christmas miracle. I don't know.
Joking. That clip on the smiling friend was just that. How many fucking people murdered this guy? Pretty sure that the GTA character is the police. If he's just a little fucking, we go and try and find what happened at something. He's our other characters just how many fucking people murdered this one guy? How many people hate this guy, I should say? What the fuck?
slabs of wood instead of green screen, and like steam was just like cotton coming up. I miss when stop motion animation was like dirty and almost entirely real. Like, I feel like there's too much CG in stop motion now. Oh, damn, alright, gotta respect the hustle. Okay, but that was like the rudest way I've ever seen anyone ask for a tip before. That fun as a kid, you grab a stick and all of a sudden you're having a blast. I'm getting flashbacks to when my parents would be like, you know, when we were kids, we didn't need all this fancy technology. You just pick up a rock and then you're transporting a rock world. Yeah, is this the kind of fun you were talking about, Mom? Unless that stick comes with a battle pass, I'm not buying it.
I'm just looking for an old well. No, it's not talking, huh?
Jeez, what are you about to torture him?
Texas or Utah, someplace dried out and barren, right?
Are you gonna try and drum up small talk right now? You look like you're here to steal her skin.
I think I heard someone calling you, Flyborn.
What? I didn't hear anything.
Oh, I definitely heard someone. Why were you
born.
Oh, get fucked, kid. It's okay. You can still recover. Here's what you do. You take a big fake yawn and you go,
oh, man, really make me do a big snooze here, Boraline.
I'm telling you, this girl won't know what fucking hit her.
I'd wear gloves next time. Why? Because that dowsing rod of yours, it's poison oak.
Oh, never mind. Nature roasted her for you.
She got Coraline.
I almost sold them well yesterday, Mom.
Yo, do you guys understand that we're about to be introduced to animation's hottest fan? Don't even try to tell me Coraline's mom isn't a dime, alright? There'd be no stopping our emotion if we got together. Dude, I'm telling you, you get me in a room with that 6-inch play figure, good night.
So, can I go out? I think it's perfect weather for gardening.
No, Coraline, rain makes mud. Mud makes a mess.
Totally, you said it. God, you're so smart.
Look what I found in this trunk. Look familiar? Wait.
Yeah, super weird. Bring that straight to the police. It was in his grandmother's trunk? What the hell is that about?
It's just raining.
What'd the boss say?
Don't even think about going out, Coraline Jones!
Dude, maybe if you typed with more than two fingers, you'd have time to hang out with your daughter. Those bags under your eyes are on you, bro. You could be typing 8 times more efficiently right now.
Go out and count all the doors and windows and write that down. List everything that's blue. Just let me work.
You're working like an asshole.
One boring little boy.
It's like the saddest painting I've ever seen. Yo, it's not my fault they gave her an absolute dump, right?
They missed it.
It's like the saddest painting I've ever seen. Yo, it's not my fault they gave her an absolute dump, right?
They must have closed this off when they divided up the house. You're kidding. And why is the door so small? We made a deal. Zip it.
Why do you guys hate your child? Why didn't you move on a weekend? Then you wouldn't have to work the second you put your box.
Think you are so nice. I give you bowls of porridge and I give you bowls of ice cream.
Why don't you ever
hurt, Mom? Coraline, this guy just wrote you a whole song about the castle. Give him a fucking break. This is 13-year-old ever receding hairline. Bitch looks like Willem Dafoe.
Just in time for supper, dear.
This intro was equal parts scary as it was a sexual awakening for me as a kid. I mean, you got other mother standing here with those leggings hugging that relentless tush. And then she turns around and you're like, oh damn, she's got buttons for eyes. But then you're like, oh damn, she's got flawless skin. And then it's like, hey, what's under that turtleneck, though?
You're not my mother. My mother doesn't have buttons. Do you like them?
She just poked her raw eye. They must be blind in this world, right? She just tapped those things with her long-ass fingernails.
Now go tell your other father that supper's ready. Well, go on. He's in his study.
God! She's working that lipstick.
Hello?
Hello? Coraline.
Yo, honestly, other father could get it too. You tell me this dude swivels around in his lounge robe like, oh, hello. And then your name. And you're not instantly ready to see what those piano hands can do?
My father can't play piano.
No need to. This piano plays me.
Dude, the sound design is so good in this movie. I love that there's no music playing during this whole scene, just like the clicks of the mechanical arms. Oh, until we start making up a song about Coraline.
We give our thanks and ask to bless our mother's golden chicken breast.
Hey, listen, I'm fine with this movie being the stuff of nightmares, but I will not have you talking about my wife's breasts like that.
Well, here comes the gravy train. Choo, choo.
I feel like I'd rather you just pass me the gravy. I mean, it's better waiting for J.P. Morgan to get his slow ass over to my bowl.
Another roll.
Corn on the cob.
Which give her one goddamn second to finish this food. This locomotive just ran a full circuit to drench those potatoes. And for what?
What on the mic?
We love this here.
My facials, my bats, my pies. It's great for poison oak.
Reel it in, OM. You're coming off a little strong here.
You better get home to my other mother.
But I'm your other mother.
I mean my other mother. Mom number one.
Ooh, big bitch.
Let's shake some baby.
Okay, well, get that thing out of the room. You guys really want her falling asleep with this 50s jazz musician catcalling her all night?
Bobinski.
Oh, let's go. Where Bobinski at?
Famous jumping mouse circus, not ready.
Seriously, Alexander Bobinski, you son of a bitch. There's my boy. She looks like the ghost of a gremlin. I wanted to grow its pubes. I love this guy.
And I am the amazing Bobinski. Call me Mr. V. Because amazing, I already know that I am.
Ladies, get yourself a Bobinski. Find you a man that knows his work.
The problem is, my new songs go oompa, oompa, but the jumping mice play only doodle doot like that.
Those fucking mice, dude, you gotta can their ass. They're playing toodle doo at an oompa oompa symphony? What kind of amateur is he working with?
Caroline, but I see. Hey!
No. Yeah, good as it is, Coraline. We'll take you far.
Thank you.
Triple G's on dolls now? Is that what we're doing? Is that how we're making a living here?
Ooh. Oh, Caroline.
Each attempt's better than the previous.
I see a very peculiar hand.
Why, is she a giraffe?
Giraffes don't just fall from the sky, Miriam.
Look, I know where this movie is headed. That was a pretty spot-on giraffe in her defense. Plus, this would be a far more exciting adventure if a giraffe somehow came into play. The fuck is this? The Upside Down?
Ha! Your cat's not wild. He's a wuss puss.
He's gonna regret calling this cat a pussy once it turns into Keith David. Is this the female gaze? This is what my pickup game's been missing my whole life?
When they were kids? Grandma's sister disappeared. She said she was stolen.
Oh my god, what? What a crazy woman. Why would you move? Why are you neighbors with a sister stealing house?
Welcome back, darling.
Dude, I can do a 360 flip off of these things. You just get me a skateboard. Is it like hill? I don't know. My job's hard, right? You are not a
would you go back to your I bet he's hungry as a pumpkin by now. You mean my other father? Your better father, dear. Spoke a little less, so I fixed him.
Cool. Yeah, that's fun. Hate that. See that? Hey, just her name spelled out in mouse anatomy. It's classy, not too in your face. Take notes, OM. Look at my boy rocking that iconic
like the new catalog. At least I love my chapters. I did not call him crazy, Coraline. He's drunk.
Nice. Mom's always ready to hit Coraline with a real splash of reality.
Are you kidding me? Had to go for shopping anyway. Dad's planning something special.
God, I can't stay mad at you. You guys see the way those hips fill out those khakis? Girl's got more game than Jake from State Farm. Working on a stop-motion film has to be the greatest test of willpower any filmmaker can undergo. I have to assume most of the process is just going, okay, but what if her hair just stayed in place for a shot?
Dearest Coraline, Miss Fink and Miss Forcible have invited you downstairs after lunch.
I really wish they did.
You must be the other.
No, I'm not the other anything. I'm me.
Bitch, that's Keith-ass David. You show him some respect.
What do you mean? She's amazing.
You probably think this world is a dream come true, but you're wrong.
Anyone who grew up with this movie's trailer constantly playing on TV has that line seared into their brain. Oh my God, what a nightmare. What an absolute nightmare. I hate their team. Can we not do this? I vaguely remember. What if she just watched the musical Cats instead? What if they just played Cats in its entirety instead of doing what they're about to?
She's practically naked.
Practically. Cats in its entirety instead of doing what they're about to.
She's practically naked.
No.
Dear Neptune, it's worse than I remember. Read the room, lady. Your audience is 40 schnauzers and 2 kids. Why do her boobs jiggle eternally? They don't stop. Dear Neptune, it's worse than I remember.
Practically naked.
Practically. Oh my God.
And who to lead Stina astray?
Dear Neptune, it's worse than I remember. Read the room, lady. Your audience is 40 schnauzers and 2 kids. Why do her boobs jiggle eternally? They don't stop jiggling. This girl's got a Newton's cradle hanging from her chest. This movie gets closer and closer to an R rating with each step she takes.
Our lives with a theater and thrill.
And then they showed me parts of their body that I have a lot of questions about.
Black is traditional.
This is such a hard sell. You can't even get a kid to go to the dentist. How are you going to convince her to have her eyes removed?
There you go. It's your decision, darling. We only want what's best for you.
Maybe if you, like, ran her through the logistics, she might be more open to it. Like, is there an anesthetic? Or are you just, like, going to town in her sock?
Don't you want to play?
Yeah, I want to hug in your face.
Yeah,
that grip's so good. Oh my God, a giraffe! Careful, Coraline, you were warned about that guy.
Bird strength and solitude. Mustn't talk to mother when I hear.
This being animated is the only thing keeping this from being a full-on horror. You think they could make this movie with this tone and live action and still sell it to kids? No chance. It's like a Stanley Kubrick film.
If you won't even talk to me, I'm gonna find the other Whitey.
No point. He pulled a long face. And mother didn't.
Why are you doing this? What are you guys gaining for making me pee in my little pants? Is that the goal here? You guys wanna see me piss me little britches?
Well, I'm getting out of here. That's what I'm doing.
Look, not that this whole film isn't gorgeous, but this, like, world breaking apart into this abstract, minimalistic art, whatever,
Like, this movie has such a great sense of, like, when there should be music, when something should be in your face, or when something should be subtle. Attaboy, Chief!
They say even the proud spirit can be broken. With love.
Yeah, I mean, shucks, you could break me. Hey,
bro.
Zanzibar. Is that any way to talk to your mother? You aren't my mother. Apologize at once.
Yo, shut the fuck up. Did you guys see those devil horns? I've never noticed that before. That's a cool little hint smooch from the filmmakers. Yo, shut the fuck up.
Is that any way to talk to your mother? You aren't my mother. Apologize at once.
Yo, shut the fuck up. Did you guys see those devil horns? I've never noticed that. That's a cool little hidden smooch from the filmmakers.
Two. Three! What are you doing?
Do I still find her as hot as before? No. But she's still, like, pretty good looking. She just looks like Angelina Jolie. You know, she's like a different kind of attractive.
Yes, miss. And hidden. Find her eyes, mistress. Your soul is fully free.
I remember this being like one of the dumber bits of the movie. I just hate these kids giving Coraline this weird Skyrim quest. Fuck that. First off, why is Wyvie all geared up and ready for the purge? How many serial killer masks do you have? Second, too far, guys. Way too far.
Come on. She hurt you again.
What do you mean he's disintegrated? Somebody help this poor kid. Where's my justice for Wyvie?
Don't you only make wings for the headphones? Just looking ahead there. Angus hasn't been feeling very well of late.
Oh my god, that dog knows. That dog knows exactly what's going on. Guys, like, help me call him. I'm not ready.
Sweetie.
What an insane way for her to get this item. Everything in this movie leading up to this point has been, like, relatively logical within its own rules. And then all of a sudden the writers are just like, and then the old lady, like, bashes the candy and just gives her the fucking thing. But sir, why was it in the candy? Because she's gotta get it somehow, and this script isn't gonna write itself by Wednesday, Johnson.
You know you are walking right into her trap.
I have to go back.
You have to go back.
Darling, why would you run away from me?
Oh, bamboos!
Perhaps they've grown bored of you and run away to France. They weren't bored of me, you stole them!
Oh god, oh jeez, here comes Pumpkin Dad. Oh, that's why he's hungry as a pumpkin. Oh, interesting, interesting, I never knew.
Why don't you have your own tea?
Only one tea.
The garden squash needs tending, don't you think, Pumpkin?
That was the scariest part of this whole film. What the hell does that string do? She just lobotomized it with one pull.
Why don't we play a game? I know you like them. Everybody likes games.
Everybody likes games, Coraline.
Must be it.
All of Pumpkin Dad should be cut from this film entirely. There, I said it!
You found me. But there's two eyes still lost. I'm getting hanged.
Settle down, Coraline. You were literally handed this first. Batch now. Why not? Where is it reaching into the candy booth? What are you doing? This is like an eldritch horror. Coraline wouldn't last a day in Yarn. Deserved none of what he got. You know what? She made a mistake turning his corpse into a flag. Because from this symbol, we shall establish the free state of Wyvie.
Same of all men. Stay.
because it's boring or doesn't make any sense. I didn't need this in my childhood.
I don't understand.
Of course you don't understand. You're just a copy of the real Mr. Gates.
Like, I don't need to see this gross sack of rats come to terms with its own mortality. I just don't need that.
So, you're back. And you brought vermin with you?
Still hot.
Forever. No, I'm
not. I love how the cat's just like, oh, you crazy bitch! I should have killed you when I had the chance! It's a nightmare. This, like, final boss arena, though, like, iconic. This movie never lets up in the visuals from beginning to end. What are you doing? Don't put that thing on your face. No wonder it's so horny in the other one.
Oh. Hello, dear. You still mad?
What does this guy have to be so mad about? You beat her.
I'm really sorry I drew that.
Oh, Drew, you did launch it.
Is overdone. What about me? You're in terrible danger, girl.
Oh, I remember. This is stupid. Just end the movie. This is so not a loose end. I also kinda hate what like the golden kids look like. I don't know. This is such a weird, unnecessary epilogue.
How's Angus doing?
Oh, much better then. But he can't suck his wounds forever.
Do you want him to die? And that is Coraline. 100% just as scary as I remember it being. It's so good, though. Controversial opinion. No, it's, like, incredible. It's like, I don't know. I'm trying to think, because it's probably one of the best, if not the best, stop-motion film ever made. I haven't seen Guillermo's Pinocchio, though. I hear that's making some waves. But no, this is just, like, I don't know, so much of it. I didn't even include a lot of the stuff. But there's so much great cinematography, great lighting work, and it's like almost all practical, which is great. Leica gets too, they like clean their stuff up too much in their later movies. Paranormans, like borderline a CGI film. The Missing Link is fine, but it's like too clean. I love how like dirty this looks. It's not entirely smooth, it's not perfectly smooth. When you see your like cooking bacon in a pan, the bubbles are marbles, you know, like, it's so good. The water is just like cellophane wrap. It's great, and then on top of that, the tone is perfect. The story's amazing, which is like sort of cheating, because it's from Neil Gaiman, but whatever. It's great, just all of its components come together to make this, like, perfect movie, except for that weird epilogue, I don't know. But yeah, like I said, leave a like on the video if you enjoyed it. Check out my page if you're new here. And let me know what other shows or movies you'd like to see me react to in the future. I'm trying...
Bouncy Mega Roll. 4 points.
This feels funny. Where did it go?
How's it going, everybody, and welcome to the most anticipated anime of the year. Everybody's freaking out about this one and wondering, is it going to be good? And honestly, who cares? All this needs to have for me to be satisfied is a man who is also a chainsaw. Anybody with higher expectations than that for a show called Chainsaw Man honestly doesn't deserve an opinion. So we're gonna get into it right now. Hey man, I get it. Times are tough. You know, I'm not gonna sit here and judge anybody for how they make their hustle. You did what? Would you sell it to a confused squirrel? What kind of person buys a testicle? What do you even do with it?
Oh,
sponge.
You mean what? Would you sell it to a confused squirrel? What kind of person buys a testicle?
I have three quality fours this one.
Oh my god, I've never seen a more adorable power tool. Hey guy, I think your chainsaw is hungry.
Hey man, I think your chainsaw is hungry.
Oh my god, I've never seen a more adorable power tool. Hey guy, beat him.
Chance of that happening. I try so hard to do this because of how fast I move. This is only 30 minutes.
Just eat trash at that point. Like, go rummaging in the back of a restaurant. No one should be eating one single slice of bread for dinner.
No, I don't want that.
Alright,
eat it! Okay, let's try.
Denji's got more self-respect than that.
Or does he?
Denji just needs some trash. Well, at least he's got a nice slice of bread waiting for him at home to wash it down.
I'm trying to maximize weevils here.
Dude, they're sharing the bread. Grass has to be a better source of nutrition at this point.
Almond milk.
Honestly, I think having one nut is probably the harder sell.
Yeah, it's gonna crash this game. Let's do it.
Some like indie sad boy vibes going on, you know? Put some Wallows posters up, maybe get some string lights. I like this wouldn't look much different from your average college dorm.
Oh wait a second. No, so Wallows is. Hell yeah, man.
No nut to nut.
Or didn't you missing that one shot?
Giant blade pointed right at your face. Oh, look at his little paws. Look at his little handles.
God damn, I moved too fast. Damn it.
I would literally take my own life for this creature.
I moved way too fast. What?
Oh my god, he's manifesting jam. You know, either that or he's dying.
I just moved so fast, I went to the I am error room.
Oh, it's a setup. Classic setup going on right here. You know, I don't really appreciate you saying stuff like this when my dog is literally right here. What the fuck? I'm literally holding him. Couldn't you have texted me this? Oh, the most casual stabbing.
He's the dog! Kill him! Jesus fucking Christ, man. This one is the definition of how to craft the Binding of Isaac. Glass eye. Give me something good. Money. Thank you. Just look in here. Oh, yes, damage and tears. Exactly what. I don't think I can possibly lose this, given how much damage I do.
ankles, Denji. You don't see me crying about it with a bunch of knives sticking out of my back.
But you don't have knives sticking out of your back, so.
And that's Chainsaw Man. It's a little overrated, if I'm being honest. And I was expecting more of like a series rather than a short film, but honestly, it was still pretty.
Okay, that might be my favorite joke about this now. This. Okay, so that's Chainsaw Man. I was expecting more, but.
Please tell me Uchida's the only one that comes back to life. I mean, it makes sense. He's more Chainsaw than Denji. Although Denji's more man than Uchida, so I guess it's still up in the air who the protagonist is. Oh, they're both gonna be the titular Chainsaw Man. Okay, but what is a normal life for a chainsaw dog? Like, would it be more normal to have him spend most of his time running around in a backyard full of toys, or hanging in somebody's garage? I'm really digging the music of the show, and how the sound design is really, like, subdued. Like, you don't hear a bunch of, like, as they're fusing, you know? It's, like, just silence and the score over it. It, like, weirdly makes this pretty gruesome scene kind of beautiful.
Maybe.
Oh my god, he talks now. You think that's gross? You should have seen how they did it. Dude, your dream of a better life is like everybody else's default. You just wanted to not be owned by the Yakuza. Those are some pretty fair aspirations. Can't blame the Yakuza? It's okay, you can blame them. Nobody's gonna cancel you for being upset with the Yakuza.
The Yakuza might cancel him. So.
Hey guy, maybe check to see if the ripcord hanging out of your chest actually does something before you hinge your entire last stand on it. Maybe it's just a cool accessory. You know, like a lip piercing. No shit, here we go. Yeah, I mean, that's a Chainsaw Man for sure.
What?
Dude, she's got three fucking chainsaws digging.
Gonna start doing stuff. Yeah, see? Jeez, cross my eyes.
Sold on the CGI yet, to be honest. Like, I don't know if this was a great example of it, but I kind of want, like, a little more fluidity, you know? Like, this guy's got three chainsaws coming out of his body, you know? Like, I want to feel the ferocity. I kind of want to see some, like, Demon Slayer or Attack on Titan levels of, like, vicious animation, you know? Okay, well, that's certainly a step in the right direction. I mean, I asked for Attack on Titan, and they literally gave it to me a second later. So I guess I'm satisfied. He's so scary looking. I love how fucked up his weird little head is, you know?
There's the fucking sacrifice room. Man, I need one.
That's so good. He just looked at this guy to death. I love the chainsaw coming out of his face, you know? What a great place to have a chainsaw. Aw, he just wants a snuggle. I super advise against it, though, on account of the fact that this man is now at least one-third chainsaw. Make sure she's not gonna feed you cigarettes first, Denji. I know how you like to jump on these kinds of offers.
Why did she... I'm not wishing I watched the sub instead of the... I'm gonna pause this. I'm gonna wish I watched the sub before I watched before the dub, just because of how fucking hot Makima sounds. It's like, hey, mommy.
Do these videos in like 2-episode chunks? I hope I'm not screwing myself over royally by not doing that this time. But looking at the recording time, it looks like this is gonna fill up a full video. And a little foreshadow for my next video, I think Blue Lock's gonna do the same. But yeah, so far super cool. I mean, it's like, it's Chainsaw Man. It's a man possessed by the spirit of a chainsaw. My expectations, and most importantly, my needs, are very low on this premise. I'm gonna need a little more convincing in terms of, like, the animation.
I'm take from that.
It's very good. But the fight scene so far isn't giving me, like B-stars level of assurance yet. I mean, like I said, I just want that. I usually don't really like Mappa's colors. Like, Jujutsu Kaisen, I don't love the colors in. Attack on Titan Season 4, I, like, hate the colors of. But this one's really cool. It looks like it's in line with, like, the latest Guilty Gear and, like, Spy Family, where it's, like, all, like, bright pastel colors, which I really love. But, yeah, let me know what you guys thought of this episode in the comments below. And I will see you guys next time. Look, I'm gonna be real with you. I've been seeing a lot of creators freaking out over the first episode of Chainsaw Man. Being like, oh my god, Chainsaw Man's the craziest anime I've ever seen in my life. Chainsaw Man's got the best first episode in anime history. And I get it. You gotta get the paycheck. You gotta ride the hype train. But best first episode in anime history? Simply false. The first episode of Chainsaw Man, very good. A very good episode of anime. The second coming of Christ? No chance. But did I expect it to be? No. I don't expect any first episode of a show to absolutely blow me out of the water. So now a couple more episodes have come out, and we're gonna see if this show lives up to its own hype. Denji, if you decide to go with Wolf, we're gonna have to have a real serious discussion. To be fair, you are one-third literal dog. Oh, I think he's doing just fine.
Yeah, that man, yeah, he's doing fine. He's doing just fine.
Sure, that's not the motor oil you're smelling. You most certainly can eat on your own. I swear to God, if this guy starts whooping. Oh my god, this is about to become the kinkiest relationship in mainstream anime history.
Fuck.
Did you miss his wolf? The dude's already gone full pooch. Type of guy she likes? Are you sure you don't want to ask her her favorite breed of dog?
What kind of dog do you like, Denji?
Dude, you don't say.
I'm a Denji. Yeah, you are a Denji. Do you want your Denji tweets? Yes.
Solid motivation. Gotta love a protagonist who's purely motivated by how hungry or horny he is at any given time.
Yep. Chainsaw Man.
Oh, this is a classic edgy rival. Why is short blue or black hair the go-to edgy rival haircut? Sasuke, Megumi, Yuno, this guy, the guy from
Megumi.
IQ. Why is every rival getting their hair done in edgy cuts?
Thank you. Bing bong.
Well, at least he's considerate. Jesus Christ, don't turn your back on Nutcracking Denji over here. Dude lifted this guy off his feet and even snuck in a thigh squeeze with that move.
Start Bethlehem. I missed it. But at least he's gonna see you.
Jesus Christ, don't turn your back on Nutcracking Denji over here. Dude lifted this guy off his feet and even snuck in a thigh squeeze with that move.
Compound flash. This one is all but it's mixed up here. Havana Canabla.
The awakened beings who hunt down these creatures are called hunters. Best strengths, they grow. Oh my god, he won't stop kicking! Why are you brutalizing this man's testing?
Stop kicking is nuts, Denji.
But the punishment is not fitting the crime here. In all of my years,
it's already my eyes. There.
Oh, in that case, by all means, keep trying to force his nuts through his spinal cord.
Oh, by all means, keep trying to force his nuts through his spinal cord.
Yo, that was the most unrealistic part of this show. Denji turning into a chainsaw demon? That I can buy. This dude standing after getting his ball sack turned into a size 11 sneaker?
Yeah, nah. Well, we're dead. Well, we should be laying on the ground going.
Oh, damn it, she's just a sexier Yakuza.
Aw, oh, man. Not the sexy Yakuza. I hate that.
I can't tell if Denji singing a song or, like, really impressed with this bathtub.
Oof. He's singing a song about how impressed he is with the bathtub.
In what grade did they teach you about fiends? Because I feel like that's got to be a pretty terrifying lesson regardless. Like, where are they slotting that information into? Social studies? Alright, class, I'll have your papers on the Trojan War graded by Monday, and next week, we're going to learn about those demons you keep seeing on your way to school. Nice bare minimum amount of remorse here. I feel like this is pretty out of character.
God, this one's broken. Oh, I see. Let me just follow that. GB bug.
Yeah, you better let go of his head. That response was fucking precious.
Soy milk.
Okay, there we go. That's more character.
Yeah, this is about to crash my game. If I fire for too long, let's do this.
Oh, he's starting to realize that there's more to life than food and sex. Wow, that was not the revelation I was expecting a character to have in a show called Chainsaw Man.
Hmm?
Never mind, we're right back on track.
Hey, what's up, Satan? Hey, how's it going? Let's get smashed.
Nice, Denji. Eyes on the prize. Don't question anything unless it gets in the
of you and a pair of tits. How about his libido?
No, what?
Oh, yes, please. I hope each new character they introduce is more psychotic than the last. I love this bloodthirsty girl. The more hype and adrenaline we could add to this show, the better. Oh, you lying bitch. Damn it, I don't know why I always trust the crazy.
I want to give up on this one.
Nice 10 full seconds of this girl's ass, guys. Real
fast. What? No. Oh, okay. It's Makima. It's reasonable. Hey, no! 10
full seconds of this girl's ass, guys. Real fast.
Yes, I was confused on what he was talking about, but when I saw it was Makima, I couldn't complain. Please, just give me another sacrifice room.
No way a devil captures a cat and doesn't immediately eat it. What else would a devil need a cat for?
Sacrifice room, please. No.
With you, buddy, but that's the kind of motivation you keep to yourself. Hey, this guy does not speak for all of us. I mean, don't get me wrong. Same, Denji. Big time same. But I don't just go around.
Yeah, don't walk up to a chick and say, I want to touch tits. Walk up to a chick and say, hi.
Say what you will about Denji, but he knows the way to a woman's heart.
Yeah, cool.
You know why the perviness in this show doesn't bother me as much as it usually does? Because it's almost done in a way that matches the show's, like, punk attitude. Like, the fact that the show has this chill, subdued tone, somehow...
Sci-fi!
...perviness feel, like, mature, sort of. Mature's probably not the right word, but I at least like that it's not all, like, spastic and annoying. Like, where Power's like, you wanna touch my breasts, you freak? She's just like, yeah, whatever, they're just boobs. You can touch them if you help me. If everyone feels a little more grounded than your typical anime, but I still don't think I'm using the right wording. I hope you guys know what I mean. Because it is still, everyone's still very anime. It's still very much an anime motivation. Which is something about the tone feels like it's
like,
not.
Listen,
not
me and Denji have the same motivations, but like he doesn't speak for all of us when he says, I want to touch your
tits. And that befriending or helping someone with the sole purpose of getting a sexual favor in return is like a real fucked up thing to do.
Yeah, really, really messed up, Denji.
But for the purposes of this anime, it's just, I like it more than I do in some other shows.
Oh, fuck.
Okay, I hear what you're saying, but Denji literally still communicates with Pochita. You know, if you just Photoshop Itadori sitting in the middle here, this would look exactly like the Jujutsu Kaisen opening. I wonder what the antagonist of the show is going to be. Like a...
Fuck!
Talking to women devil? That's some scary shit.